First up this morning, another immigration bungle is in the spotlight, heaping pressure on Minister Andrew Giles to stand aside.
Nine Federal Politics reporter Eliza Edwards is live in Parliament House with more for us. Eliza, good morning. This saga is over visas for foreign-born criminals.
Yes, Aaron Carl, Minister Andrew Giles is now facing scrutiny over his use of a relatively new ministerial direction known as Direction 99. This makes it harder to cancel the visas of foreign nationals with strong ties to Australia. There are suggestions around 25 criminals have been allowed to stay in the country as a result. The Australian reporting it includes a serial rapist with more than two dozen victims who was allowed to keep his visa. All of these cases are now under review, but this latest immigration saga is raising questions about Minister Giles' future. His own department admitting some fault, saying they failed to keep him in the loop about certain problematic cases. But ultimately, the opposition says the buck stops with the minister. Guys.
Eliza, thank you.
There's breaking news in Melbourne's west, where another tobacco store has been targeted in a firebombing attack. Let's bring in today Melbourne reporter Isabella Stashkovsky at the scene in Footscray. Isa, good morning. Police say those involved may have fled in a car.
Yeah, that's certainly right, Carl. Good morning to you. And this is just really relentless at this point. We're here on Paisley Street in Footscray. It was about just before 3 this morning that this business here was targeted. We understand that the front windows were smashed in, and police say that someone threw in what they believe to be a Molotov cocktail. You can see that that fire has now been very much put out. There is a police car, though, and police tape signifying that it is certainly a crime scene at this point of the morning. We know that there will be more investigations later as more teams do come here right throughout the morning. It's understood that those offenders, though, they made their way off in a vehicle, and police have said that they do believe that this attack is very much targeted. Anyone with information is being asked to come forward as those investigations continue right throughout the morning. Carl?
Is it? Thank you.
Now, homicide detectives have swarmed a street in Sydney's eastern suburbs where a man was stabbed to death. Let's bring in today's Sydney reporter Jack Hunt on this. Jack, good morning. Forensic investigators are right now gathering evidence.
Yeah, that's right. You can see them behind us. In fact, we've got forensics in all white PPE alongside plain clothes officers in general duties. Police, they are still on the scene almost 12 hours after being called to this address in Matraville just after 6 o'clock last night, finding a man with serious stab wounds. Despite ambulance paramedics attempting CPR, he could not be revived, dying here at the scene. A short distance away, a woman was placed under arrest, and this morning she is in police custody but is helping with the investigation. The state's homicide squad has been put on the case, but they are not jumping to any conclusions just yet. They are taking their time to work through the series of events, and no charges have been laid, Brooke.
Okay, thank you, Jack. China has been at the forefront of discussions at a defence forum in Canberra overnight. The Deputy Prime Minister Richard Miles attending alongside military leaders, acknowledging the increased anxiety around China's recent military drills, but admitting he wants to keep a strong relationship with the country.
We want to have the most productive relationship with China that we can have. I mean, they remain our largest trading partner. But when we talk about, working with them when we can, but disagreeing where we must.
The Deputy PM also reaffirmed AUKUS is essential to Australia's defence strategy. A driver is in a critical condition this morning after a deadly crash claimed 2 lives in Sydney's west. A motorcycle and a hatchback colliding at the intersection of the Hume Highway and Worth Street at Greenacre at about 7 p.m. The impact flipping the car, killing the motorbike rider and a passenger. On the Gold Coast, a car has been crushed after crashing into another vehicle and flipping on its roof. It's understood the 55-year-old driver of the white Toyota managed to escape, fleeing before emergency crews arrived. A 69-year-old woman who was inside the Mazda has been taken to hospital in a stable condition.
Happening now, Donald Trump's lawyers are making their final plea to the jury in his historic hush money trial. 9 US correspondent Alison Petrowski is outside court in New York. Ali, good morning to you. Michael Cohen's credibility is at the heart of their closing arguments.
It sure is, Carl. Good morning to you. Marathon closing arguments for this landmark
Mark Case. And normally what happens in most criminal trials here in America and also here in Australia is that prosecution lays out its closing arguments first, but not the case here in New York, Carl. Bit of a quirk in their system. Instead, the defence has to lay out their case. And so it is that Donald Trump's lawyer, Todd Blanche, has taken aim at Michael Cohen, Trump's former fixer this morning, painting him as a disgruntled ex-employee with an axe to grind, saying he was basically profiting from his relationship with the former president. Blanche telling the jury, you should expect more from the testimony of Michael Cohen. Michael Cohen lied to you. Now, Carl, it is always a bit of a circus outside the courthouse here in Lower Manhattan. This morning, we saw New York native actor Robert De Niro come down, and he wanted to give a warning to Americans about what a second Trump presidency could bring.
We'd forgotten the lessons of history that showed us other clowns who weren't taken seriously until they became vicious dictators. With Trump, we have a second chance, and no one is laughing now. This is the time to stop him by voting him out once and for all.
Today, Donald Trump was flanked by his two eldest sons, Eric and Don Jr., as well as his daughter-in-law, Lara Trump. Notably, Carl, there was no Ivanka and no Melania. Neither of those two have made an appearance throughout this entire trial. I managed to talk to Eric Trump during the lunch break today. I asked him how he thought his dad's lawyer had been doing, and he said he thought that Todd Blanche had been doing an exceptional and brilliant job and that his family were proud of Todd Blanche. Carl, the prosecution is now laying out its closing arguments before this landmark case gets handed to a jury of 12 New Yorkers.
Ali, thank you.
A mother has become the victim of a vicious road rage attack south of Brisbane. A man filmed smashing her car window in Logan Reserve before allegedly assaulting the woman, aged in her 30s, who suffered minor head injuries.
The truck pulled up alongside and jumped out, and he was banging on the window and saying, "Get out, get out." I saw some people pull over to help them, and the lady in the back got out and had blood all over her face.
The alleged attacker is still on the run. Adelaide's miracle man, Sam May, could soon be back on the field. The West Adelaide footballer now back at home recovering after suffering life-altering injuries when he fell through the roof of the Pier Hotel in Port Lincoln. The 24-year-old is said to be in good spirits. New this morning, three men have been charged over a fraudulent e-tag scheme worth millions. The trio is accused of selling e-tags linked to false credit cards bought on the dark web. Up to 800 devices were put into circulation over 5 years, most of them used in taxis. Police charging a 28-year-old and two men in their 30s after raids allegedly uncovered more tags and cash. No, the Muffin Man.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You do? Well, Melburnians have sharpened their pitchforks, furious over a cafe sneakily charging a man $1 to heat up this muffin.
Oh.
Yes, the diner venting on social media over the cost he found on his receipt. The cafe has fired back, saying the charge was a mistake, although the receipt does have the label fee as heat standard.
Mm.
There you go.
Wasn't the muffin man I was thinking? back in the day when muffin break used to be a thing, they had this awesome, you know, mascot,
mm-hmm.
and we found love for the muffin man.
Oh yeah,
yeah, oh,
with,
yeah.
With the big banana, as it were. Okay. And there was literally
so there
found love on the show.
There are those antihistamines and painkillers we've been talking about.
No, it's true.
You're in for a wild ride. If I were you, I would not turn your TV.
I'll find the vision.